At one point in the first half, you guys were outscoring them 21-0 on turnovers. Just what was working so well for you guys defensively early on?
Oh, they play so fast that, you know, if you stay in between your man and the basket, you know, you'd be in good position to get steals and deflections, and I think we did a good job of that. We didn't let people get behind us on backdoor cuts, and we used hot hands when they were passing out top, and, you know, so sometimes we made them rush a little bit, get turnovers, and, you know, that's key for us. If we can get out and get on the break, that'll help our offense.
And since we won't see you before then, you know, the last time you guys played Milwaukee was like, you know, 5 games in the season. You guys had still bringing a lot of guys back and whatnot. Just, you know, an early thought on that matchup since you last saw them.
It's a championship caliber team that's going to give us a tough test, and we're all looking forward to it.
Kevin, when Jacques calls one of those quick timeouts like he did at the beginning of the game after like a botched defensive possession, what does he say to you guys? Because you guys seem to respond well to those.
Just lock back in. I mean, we understand we made a mistake, but to, you know, have your coach come back and, everybody on the bench and the coaching staff reiterate what happened, and we can watch it on the tablet and see, it's always beneficial for us. So I love when he does that. I mean, that just keeps us on point, keeps the coaching staff and everybody on point, the arena on point, just knowing that we're trying to win this game, you know. So I like the sense of urgency, and Jock's been doing that since he became a coach, and I think I was about to say he does it. He's been doing it less, but I feel like the last couple of games he's been calling them quick timeouts. So we don't want to have him do that, you know, going forward. You know, we want to try to play through that stuff. And but I appreciate that as a player.
Kevin, why do you think the offense has clicked the way it has for this stretch now, the last few weeks?
Making shots. I mean, we've been, you know, it's a make or miss league. You know, we've been generating solid shots all year. I think they're just starting to fall now, and it's going to come a time where, you know, some of those shots, like, what game was it? A couple games ago, I think in the first half, I want to say Toronto, we struggled shooting the ball a little bit, and we was able to ramp it up on defense, and then we started making shots after that. So, you know, it was about shooting the ball with confidence, being aggressive downhill to make plays for others, and tonight was one of those nights.
Kevin, you're at a career high in field goal percentage, career high at the rim, mid-range on pull-ups. Do you feel like this is the easiest or the best you've been as a shooter or scorer, or at least the most efficient?
Yeah, you could say that. I mean, I never shot this high percentage before. Just thinking the game a little bit different than I was before. I always felt like I could shoot this well, but I think I'm just the quality of shots and the looks that I'm getting and my focus level and my fundamentals is what's keeping me there. Sometimes I shoot the ball and pull it back or fade back. My upper body be fading when I shoot, and it may be short or shoot an off-balance shot. So I'm just trying to stay focused on straight up and down, just using my fundamentals every time I get a good look, and I'm starting to knock them down. Just keep putting that work in between games, and keep visualizing what I want to do out there, and, you know, I'll be fine.
Do you think the time off while you're rehabbing, like, went into that? Because your percentages have jumped quite a bit as a shooter.
It's just about thinking the game and just staying true to what I do. If I find an area on the court that I like, I try to exploit it. If I find a matchup, I try to exploit it. I just try to play the game, a cerebral game. And I was 1-for-9 coming out in the third quarter. You know, so it's good to go through that type of stuff to see, all right, where can I make adjustments and how can I be better on those shots and so they can fall into the rim next time. So it's all about making adjustments, checking the film, you know, analyzing in your brain what went on, just replaying stuff back, you know, just always just trying to think the game on a different level than I was before.
The way you guys are playing and the way you've played pretty much all season, you think there's people regretting now maybe you're not playing this weekend?
Knicks Nets would have been great Christmas Day matchup. That's what you're talking about, right?
Any place having you on the schedule, but yeah, certainly that would.
So a Christmas game, right?
Yeah.
It's probably some people, especially with the way Knicks playing, the way we playing right now. I felt like that'd have been a perfect matchup on Christmas. Hopefully, we can get that going forward. But I probably do have. Is responsible for us not playing on Christmas with what went on this summer. But, hey, it is what it is. We play on the 26th. That's close enough.
Steve Kerr joke before the game that he was going to hunt you down and try to convince you to play for Team USA again this summer. Just A, did that happen? And B, when can you even make a decision on that? Can you make it now, or do you have to wait to see?
I'm definitely not going to make it now. I love my Team USA family. I always want to represent my country, my city, my block, my friends, my family. I mean, they give me an opportunity to go on that platform in front of the whole world and showcase what my people taught me since I was a kid. So I definitely got to think about it. But I would say it's too early right now. They respect my timeline and where we are in the season. And, you know, and we all always in constant communication on, you know, what we want to do going forward. So I had that conversation when it's time, but for right now, I don't know.